Hey guys, it's Mike Chen. You know, researchers have always been trying to figure out the origins of life, the origins of this planet, the origins of the solar system, and everything we think we know about that may now be called into question because of the discovery of a small pebble that contains compounds that are not only not found anywhere on this planet, it's not found anywhere in this solar system. But let me start from the beginning. In the western part of Egypt lies the Great Sand Sea, which covers a whopping 28,000 square miles and spills over into eastern Libya. And one region of this vast desert is littered with yellow glass whose origins many scientists believe to be otherworldly. And while investigating this glass field, small stones containing diamonds were discovered that challenge all preconceived notions about the formation of our solar system. In 1996, Dr. Ali A. Barakat was exploring an area of the Great Sand Sea that is abundant in desert glass. Known as the Libyan Desert Glass Strewn Field, this 25,000 square mile region is covered in pieces of yellow glass that perplexes researchers. Now, the glass is very similar to trinitite, the glass formed in the New Mexico desert underneath the first atomic bomb explosion that was nicknamed Operation Trinity. And this glass was very important to the ancient Egyptians, as evidenced by its use in jewelry that adorned the mummies of the pharaohs, including Tutankhamun. Anyway, Barakat's 1996 exploration collected a few pieces of seemingly unspectacular stones that were surrounded by this mysterious yellow glass. These stones have been named after Hypatia, who was a famous female astronomer and mathematician in Alexandria, Egypt during the 4th and 5th centuries AD. And upon further analysis of the noble gas and nitrogen isotopes, it was announced in 2013 that these stones were extraterrestrial in origin. This was followed by a 2015 announcement stating that the Hypatia stones were not from any known comet or meteor impact. Also, what really made the scientists sit up and take notice was the revelation that the stones were almost pure carbon with very little silica, the opposite of what is observed in every other meteor or comet fragment analyzed to date. Furthermore, the shock diamonds have unusual nitrogen isotope ratios unlike those found on Earth, leading researchers to believe that they were formed before the mysterious impactor entered our atmosphere. According to lead researcher Jan Kramers, we can think of the badly mixed dough of fruitcake representing the bulk of the Hypatia pebble, what we called two mixed matrices in geology terms. The glazed cherries and nuts in the cake represents the mineral grains found in Hypatia inclusions, and the flour dusting the cracks of the fallen cake represent the secondary materials we found in the fractures in Hypatia, which are from Earth. This baking analogy gets even stranger due to the presence of a few exceedingly rare components, because pure metallic aluminum was found. And aluminum is really never found in this form on the Earth, and it's thought to be extremely rare even in our solar system. Also, an even more astounding discovery was an alloy of phosphorus and nickel that contains no iron. This has really never been observed before. Kramers went on to say, even more unusual, the matrix contains a high amount of very specific carbon compounds called polyaromatic hydrocarbons, or PAH, which is a major component of interstellar dust, which existed even before our solar system was formed. Interstellar dust is also found in comets and meteorites that have not been heated up for a prolonged period in their history. Basically, the South African professor believes the data is telling him that the formation process must have happened very far from the warmth of a star like our sun. And these are regions of our solar system that we currently know very little about. Kramers also noted that Hypatia was formed in a cold environment, probably at temperatures below that of liquid nitrogen on Earth. In our solar system, it would have been way further out than the asteroid belts between Mars and Jupiter, where most meteorites come from. Comets come mainly from the Kuiper belt beyond the orbit of Neptune, and about 40 times as far away from the sun as we are. Some come from the Oort cloud, even further out. We know very little about the chemical compositions of space objects out there. So our next question will dig further into where Hypatia came from. Now, if this yellow glass was formed by Hypatia exploding with the force of an atomic bomb, leaving only tiny pieces of itself as clues for further researchers, in that case, where is the crater? It turns out that one potential candidate for the crater, created from the events that produced all of this nuclear glass, was too big to be seen except from space. And it wasn't until 2007 when Egyptian scientists analyzed data collected by orbiting satellites that they discovered what they believed to be a 19-mile diameter crater that could very well explain the origins of the desert glass and Hypatia stone fragments. But due to its very remote location, there really has been very little additional research done about it. So yeah, a lot of questions contained in a tiny little pebble. Also, I wonder, you remember the story about King Tut's dagger that was made with meteorite? I wonder if that's somehow related to the Hypatia stones. Anyway guys, let me know your thoughts on this story in the comments below. Thank you all so much for watching. I'll see you later.